there lived a man, and Larry was his name. And in the days of the Cape Horn trade, he played the Shanghai game. His wife's name was Mary Ann, sailors knew both near and far. Mrs. and Larry would prime the beer from the big 5 gallon jar. In the old Virginia lowlands, lowlands, low. In the old Virginia lowlands, low. There were 5 or 6 drunken shellbacks standing in before the bar, and Larry was serving them from the big 5 gallon jar. A hell ship she was short of hands, all full red-blooded tars. Mrs. and Larry would prime the beer from the big 5 gallon jar. In the old Virginia lowlands, lowlands, low. In the old Virginia lowlands, low. Shellbacks and farmers just the same, sail into Larry Mars and sail away around the horn, helped by the big stone jar. And in Frisco town their names is known, as is the Cape Horn bar, for the dope that they served out to Jack from the big 5 gallon jar. In the old Virginia lowlands, low. From old Larry Mars, or else dance soon Shanghai you'll be by the big 5 gallon jar. Shanghai the whale, the skysail ship around the horn so far. So it's goodbye to all those boys and girls and Larry's 5 gallon jar. In the
music for the Winster Morris Dancers.
And
it's interesting, isn't it? The Winster Morris Dancers, they're very, very funny about the mention of having women involved in the Winster Morris side, which is interesting. I keep having this argument with them, and they never refute the fact that I give to them, but they still want to have women inside. But in actual fact, if it wasn't for women, both in the First World War and the Second World War, Winster probably wouldn't exist now. The women actually took over. They didn't necessarily dance the Morris dancers, maybe once or twice, but they danced country dancers in the meantime. But the fact is that women played a very big role in keeping the Winster side alive. So well done, women. But what's really interesting is that in the Winster Morris tradition, it's all men. But down one side is women, and down the other side is men.
That's what they call the lines. The men's side and the women's side.
Yeah, and the men's side wear hats with no flowers in, and the women's side wear hats with flowers in, to denote men and women. What's that all?
They are actually removable, these rings of flowers. So it's sort of the quickest sex change as you've ever seen.
Anyway, nevertheless, we love it, and that's a fantastic bunch. They are changing. just very, very slowly, they're morphing into normal people. So here we go. A couple of tunes from the Winster tradition. Less well-known tunes. There's probably a reason for that. It's the it's a second tune. The first tune we're going to play is actually called The Blue-Eyed Stranger. Well, it's not. The dance is called The Blue-Eyed Stranger. And the tune is actually Shave the Donkey in Jig Time. Don't ask. Funny is. And the second tune we're going to play is called Joe P, or Joe P's. Seems like a strange title for a Morris stamp. So that's because Joe P Raines, in the 1950s, was an old man by then, but he was one of the original sign before it broke up and reformed some years later. And when he died, the side wrote a dance in his honour, but they couldn't make it, they weren't good enough to make up a tune for it, so they borrowed one from just down the road in Wensley, which the tune is called The Blue-Eyed Stranger. It doesn't help people like me. But so we've got The Blue-Eyed Stranger dance with Shave the Donkey and Joe P. Joe P. Raines was also the grocer in Winster, which is why they called him Joe P. Well, it wasn't, because his middle name began with P, so I all of it. But anyway, there you go. Anyway, two shows then from the Winster tradition.